And my last question, traditional ship owners like yourself raise money through the business, but also raise money by being listed, especially in the New York Stock Exchange. Now, I've also talked to a number of you that have told me that in hindsight, they would prefer to be on their own. How do you feel by having investors, some of them that have no idea about shipping, pressuring you, I'm not talking to you, about talking about you personally, but pressuring people with deep knowledge in the field to take decisions that sometimes go against ship owner's difference?
First of all, I want to say that I tested the water and I still believe it is a good source of funds when the market, the bank, banking is completely closed. And it was a good opening for raising funds in order to expand in LNG business, which is high capital intensive. But our involvement there was just 6 out of the 17 vessels that we have, we made. And what is my, let's say, I'm not an expert, but this small experience that I have in these 4 years that we're in public. There is a completely mismatch between ship owner's approach, it was also mentioned before, and the ship owner. The shareholder wants the highest dividend possible. We traditionally must keep liquidity like a spare part for the bad moment. So when you have the good days, they expect everything to be distributed. This is the first big mismatch. Because in shipping, we have the good days and the bad days. We have, since the times of Pharaoh, the 7 lean years and the 7 good years. And if you are not prepared in the good years for the bad years, you have a problem. Secondly, they are eager to invest when the market is to disinvest. So these two, I believe, these two issues are very different from the other businesses, because shipping is the most transparent industry. Always you know the owner, the running cost, the earning capacity, and the capability of the one to the other is few hundred dollars difference in running cost or in chartering the vessels. There is no other industry that you know how much the car factory costs, the unit cost, what is, who is the owner, the 10,000 or 100,000 shareholders, and so on. So shipping is the most transparent business. Unfortunately, with all this over-regulation, the banks have lost the target. Instead of seeing how they make money, they see how they make regulations and how they imply enforce the regulations. So the front office is 3 people and the back office is 33 people. So this is not a recipe to make money, so the banks have gone out. So there is now the vacuum where the Chinese are coming in.